Through joint ventures with industry and utilities, Fort Bliss is on its way to being a net zero installation by 2015. That's 15 years before the Army's 2030 target.
When General Pritard and Colonel Simonelli invited me here, they said, you have to see what we're doing here at Bliss. You have to see what we're doing for energy, for the environment, for soldiers and their families.
Achieving net zero would mean producing more renewable energy than is consumed. Fort Bliss Commander Major General Dana J.H. Pritard said the post is pursuing this goal not only in energy, but also in waste and water.
Right now, we still use potable water to water our lawns, which to me is almost criminal. So we're working with the city of El Paso, and we'll be able to water our lawns with gray water by the end of this year.
Fort Bliss officials said they are confident that they will meet the Army's sustainability goal. Fort Bliss Garrison Commander Colonel Joseph Simonelli said there are various ways the post is pursuing this.
We're relying on the technology at hand, coupled with the technology that's going to be developed in the next few years.
With less than 5 years for the installation to achieve net zero, Renewable Energy Program Manager for the Director of Public Works, B.J. Tomlinson, said he hopes visitors like Secretary Hammack leave with a visual recollection of the accomplishments Fort Bliss has had up to this point.
And when she starts seeing these projects flow up to her level, that she remembers being out here at Fort Bliss and she helps them move along so that way we can move along faster.
Reporting for Fort Bliss, I'm Lieutenant Colonel Diana Bagay.
That's the Army Today from Soldiers Radio and Television in Washington, D.C.